Thank you, Rachel. So the framework of this work is in a part of my lab in the University of Tours, CNRS, and another with the MASA consortium. Not this one? No? Oh, so, like this. The MASA consortium from about a memory of archaeologists on the archaeological site is a consortium of several French institutions working in archaeology, many laboratories of the CNRS. The MASA consortium has been approved by Humanum, a very large research infrastructure for digital humanities in France. The MASA consortium mission is to produce good practice guidelines to help researchers better choose digital. Digital format and find a long-term and interoperable solution based on the. Based on the knowledge that archaeological data are accumulating and that computerization has become widespread. To this aim, an important work has been launched to solve the problem of heterogeneity of data systems on infrastructure, on structures in archaeology. This need is not specific to archaeology, but more largely in other disciplines. Archaeologists work on the same study objects, but have wide variety of ways of describing this object on structuring information. When we worked with the computer scientists, CyDoc theorem appeared as an interesting solution to make heterogeneous data interoperable. Each data set can be linked to the domain ontology by matching the different elements of the data set of the CRM entities. Since the single application will be able to query various data sources regardless their structure of or initial format. Beyond interoperability, a goal of MASA consortium is also to bring archaeological data from fieldwork to the Lincoln Open Data. As you know, probably this schema, Lincoln Open Data, it was a quotation for the Lincoln Open Data with a five star level. First is the data. Are accessible on the web, regardless of their format. The data is structured and matching readable. Three, the data are presented in a non-proprietary format. Four, the data is in a standard W3C format, like RDF, for example. On five, the data is interoperable. We also take a look at the FAIR principle, at the FAIR data principle. FAIR principle have been established to guide data producer and publisher to improve and clarify the management of their data to be findable, to be accessible, to be interoperable, and to be reusable. This will mainly used in the field of digital humanities. And for each of category, it was the needed to be according for the FAIR principle. In our labs, we try to see how we are competing with the, with this two score load on the 5-star load on the fair principle. We conducted an inventory of the state of progress of our main databases to evaluate, to assess the work that must still be done on each of our datasets, of each of the datasets. This is often the oldest datasets that require the most work to make them interoperable. Currently, as to the question of reuse of published data, we have not yet considered the issue of the licenses on right to reuse the data, but we assume that is public data and that anyone can use it at their wish. And we structure all our online data using the CIDOC CRM, the ontology of to cultural heritage domain, at the basis of interoperability of our data. The work carried out on interoperability on CIDOC CRM within MASA was based on the ARSOL database, which is the database of our labs, ARSOL for archive of soil. It's a 4D software database, a proprietary system, that we have been developing and using for over 30 years. A few years ago, we set up a web application to display your data, so ARSOL happened to be a good candidate to test our research with CIDOC CRM within the consortium. The first step was to become familiar with the CIDOC CRM and understand its logic. At this step, many discussions with Patrick Leboeuf from the French National Library allowed us to set our first mapping like this. We begin by formalizing a diagram representing all the matches between our data and entities specifying the tree structure within the ontology. Here is an example with the grave table. In the second time, we used the free software Protégé with its extension on top, developed by the University of Bolzano in Italy. And our colleague Beatrice Markov, a computer scientist from the University of Tours, advised us on this solution and helped us to implement the software architecture. The application Protégé with OnTop allows us to load an ontology, explore its tree structure, connect to a database, and create mappings to associate database fields with ontology entities. The result is stored in a specific format, OBDA, it's for ontology based data access. Then, thanks to a reasoner, OnTop makes it possible to write a Sparkle query based on the entity and property of the ontology, and thanks to the mapping, the OBDA file. And to return the result of a query from the source database. Unfortunately, the sitting on top and writing the query in Sparkle are not available to all of us, to all archaeologists. So it's also planned with the MASA consortium. We'll work on implementing a user-friendly interface for querying multiple datasets. Of course, the intention is to publish on the Lincoln Open Data, but we also hope to demonstrate the efficiency of the of interoperability for archaeologists. For ARSOL database, it's only 2-star Lincoln Open Data can be allowed. the 5 stars could be given because the base will soon be interoperable. So should we take the time to migrate our data in an open format while solution allow to us to make them interoperable? In order to verify that ASOL is truly interoperable, we need to find other DBMAs with the same granularity, archaeological fieldwork. But it is quite difficult to find data set at the scale at this scale on the web. Indeed, online data are mainly inventory of sites or operation or catalog, object, drive, epigraphy, and so on. A second corpus was used to test the mapping with Hydrox CRM. This is an atlas of a rural settlement of Ocean Beauce in the center of France, inventory of ancient farming sites in Beauce, as seen by aerial survey or field survey. The scopus is managed directly online, and the data, the data is stored in an XML format. We started also to creating a schema to visualize the match between the entities and XML element on the dataset. In a second step, we use the 3M online tools to formalize the mapping of the AIRBA dataset with Hydrox CRM. The forces ICS team, including Maria Teodoridou, helped us to improve these mappings. We took advantage to this opportunity to translate the 3M user manual into French to help our Francophone colleagues to handle it. In the case of AIRBA corpus, the choice of formalizing data in XML from the outset enables to win the first 4 stars, and there is much less to earn starts when a project starts today rather than for all datasets. In the case of ASOL, as in the case of ASOL, we need other datasets to the same scale, the region, to test interoperability. Finally, I would like to present the last work we are currently completing. This is a logicist writing publication of the result of the excavation of the Rigny Parish Center. For this publication, Elisabeth Zaloario has formalized her archaeological reasoning according to the precept of Jean-Claude Gardin, thus proposing a clear structuring of the logic of inference. Inferences allowing going from field observations to the most synthetic interpretation. The entire publication has been written in the XML TIE format, and colleagues at the University of Caen have developed a web application to browse this tree structure and rate the publication according to the level of detailed desired. It is so possible to limit oneself to synthetic levels or to deepen the reading by going as far as fieldwork data, information directly linked to ASOL online. Thus, in the text, the links of archaeological features point directly to the detailed records in the ASOL database. In addition, XML has automated the creation of a SVG diagram to visualize the inference tree structure. Now we are turning us with interest to the CRM ENF for inference, an extension of CDOC CRM, to try to map this logicist publication with the CRM ENF. The combination of logicism and CRM-ENF could be exploited as a writing aid for new forms of synthetic, scientific publication based on the full demonstration of argumentation of on inferences between synthesis on corpus of evidence. A multiplication of this type of publication should allow the formalization of knowledge basis on the rules of inference that will make archaeological reasoning more robust. In both cases, it is the modeling of the reasoning which constitutes a contribution of knowledge in itself. As for the other data sets, we started by formalizing the mapping through the synthetic schema. It includes all the elements that constitute the CRM-INF extension, as well as some elements of the CRM science extension concerning the field observation data used as evidence to support the first proposal of the archaeological reasoning. In this case, like in the foregoing, the first four stars are reached for the fives. We will again need similar corpus. To conclude, we are looking for online datasets about archaeological fieldwork to test the interoperability of the ASOL database. We also want to test interoperability at different scales for databases with different granularities, fieldwork and regional inventories. We're trying to use the CRM-INF to model the archaeological reasoning and make it possible to build a new knowledge base with upcoming archaeological publication oriented to the logicist model. Finally, the work carried out within the MASA consortium in recent years has convinced our colleagues that it is essential to make our data interoperable. However, few archaeologists are embarking on the adventure of CIDOC CRM. Firstly, because very few databases are accessible on the web at the granularity of the primary data. And secondly, because the understanding of CIDOC CRM itself is seen as a long and too complex learning process, as Rachel said this morning. Also, we organized a training session using the CardGram created by George Buchsecker and Anaïs Guilhem, creating an instance of dealing with archaeological excavation example as a pedagogical support. Anaïs and George will talk about game at the end of this session. So, thank you.